Cut that fucking shit, man. Cut that motherfucking shit. Anyway.
And it's cut.
Welcome to the all-new fucking Jeff Hagy Show, and people are saying they can't hear me. It's too low. What in the fuck hell, shit piss?
I told you sounded a little low.
I don't know why, dude.
Can you guys hear Tyndall okay? Let me know if you can hear me okay. We'll see what's going on.
Maybe
the music clearly was K.
The what?
The music, both are low. That's really weird.
How do I sound now? I turned my shit up.
Yeah, I turned the gain up. How about now, guys? How about now?
How does that sound?
We might have had the gain too low. Did you turn your gain up? Give it a second. I think we're going to... Yeah, there we go.
Tyndall's didn't touch good. My gain. I just went into the fucking shit. Like, I had my shit on Discord turned all the way down.
Hagy is still low. Just turn your gain up, like, a couple notches and you'll be good. Because that's what
you
I did.
Really, you can't really go by one...
Just...
When you say... It sounds fine, and one person says it sounds like shit.
Well, I mean, I would turn it up a couple notches and call it a day. Just turn your gain up a little bit, and you'll be good.
All right. How do I sound now?
I mean, to me, you sound fine. It's just...
I don't know. Some people say it sounds good. Some people say it sounds too low.
My speakers are max Nagy's low. I've got you maxed in Discord, and...
Yeah, it's low on my end too. Like, it sounds perfect through Discord, but I have it open on YouTube and the volume is maxed out and I can barely hear it.
You guys sound fine to me.
Just turn your gain up. That's the easiest.
Damn, I can't have it up that loud, dude. Then I sound like...
Nah, you sound fine.
Alright, well, some people say it sounds fine.
Yeah, T, turn your gain up, too. Everybody turn your gain up.
Fuck the gain.
I think you guys are all, like, behind in the stream or something. Fuck it. Deal with it. Some people can hear us. If you can't, then put on subtitles. I don't really fucking care.
Anyway. Now I fucked my whole shit up here. Where the hell was I? Back to that. So, anyway. New shit. What's up, y'all? Glad that you're all here. We have some, we have a lot of shit lined up for you guys tonight. A lot of shit we want to talk about. Man, I'm getting sick of seeing people saying this so low.
I have everything maxed.
Dude, now I fucked up and I can't get back into the fucking shit. Oh, fuck. I fucked up. Oh, there we go. Let me try to fix something here.
People are difficult. I'm seeing.
Yeah,
what
I don't know.
Do.
I don't know why it's so low.
Yep, that's an 100.
We didn't.
There's not anything else I can do, dude. I have you completely maxed. It has to be on your end, dog.
Yeah, but it's not. It's not just Hagy. It's all three of us.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, well, there's only some people were saying it's low, and some were saying not. I mean, what the.
I think it's a YouTube thing, honestly.
Yeah, see, and the people who I know are saying, like, we sound fine, and then, like, people who I don't know who they are saying it sounds like shit. So fine.
Well, it could be a YouTube thing as well, because I've noticed live streaming has had some issues recently. See,
try
I'm
to
getting...
Refresh your shit, maybe. I don't know.
I'll stop.
Not you, them.
All right.
Yeah.
If you guys are having problems, just close everything. Come back. Should be good.
It's not on our end. It's on your end. Like this is.
It's got to be. I mean, it's got to be. Everything on my end is checking out. I'm sorry, guys. Just restart your shit.
Yeah, it's on your end. So anyway, we're gonna start it off. Do you guys start off like talking about fucking this Jake Paul fuck right away or what?
I want to hear what you have to say about Jake Paul. I think you need to roast and expose Jake Paul.
All right, so I didn't even know who this fucker was for the longest time. And I'm seeing all this hype shit on Twitter, on YouTube, about this Jake Paul fucking jabroni. And to me, I'm like, you know, honestly, and I ain't saying, I'm not talking shit about like homosexuals, but I thought he was like some gay guy everybody was picking on, right? So I'm like, let me do some investigating. So here he's just some fucking Disney jabroni. Like, let me, my question for everybody is, why does everybody who starts off on Disney, like, end up being, like a piece of shit? Like, why is that, man?
I think Disney brainwashes people, dude.
You know, it's like everybody, like Justin Timberlake, big time jabroni. Britney Spears done shaved her head and went crazy. What the fuck?
I don't know, dude, but it just seems like Disney just fucks with people, dude.
So this is Jake Paul, right? So he lights up a mattress, like, out in his backyard? Like, dude.
Oh, he put a bunch of shit in his pool and lit it on fire in the middle of summer in California where there's tons of wildfires. It was a very bad idea.
Yeah, and then, like, did you guys see on the news when that guy rolled up and was asking him a question? He was played out, like, 3 years ago. Who the fuck says dad? Do you remember that shit?
Yeah, I mean, the kid is 20 years old, so he's an idiot. I mean, I mean, remember, he doesn't look like he's 20, even though he's playing like a 16-year-old kid on the Disney Channel, because they're totally not selling sex to underage girls, guys. They're totally not doing that. Well, Disney would not do that.
And then he says to the fucking guy interviewing, he goes, I only have one question for you. What are those? And he points at my man's, like, $500 fucking gator shoes, and he's trying to hate. It's like, dude. You're 20. You don't know about style. You're a fucking idiot. You know what I mean? It's like, this fucking guy, man. Jake Paul is like, dude, like, where did he come from? Like, dude, where did he come from?
No. Here's where he came from. See, did you ever hear of Vine?
Yeah. Back in the day, Vine, yeah.
Yeah, so basically what happened is Vine shut down, and all those big Viners came over to YouTube, and ever since they did, all hell has broken loose.
But this guy just, like, he just seems like a fucking, he dude, I don't even know. He just seems like a fucking idiot. Like, and what is it with trying to impress a bunch of 8-year-olds? You know what I mean? Like, what is that all about? Like, Larry Lounge style. Like, why are you basing, did I just talk about Larry Lounge?
We're not there yet. We're not there yet. You're jumping ahead of the program here. Stick to the topic.
All right. T, are you there? Tea?
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yeah, you drinking whiskey's tea?
I am.
We don't want an aftermath of last time, T.
Hey, you no, turn your gain I'm up like two more notches, please.
Dude, fuck it. If you can't hear me, leave.
Oh God, I'm sorry, guys. I tried.
I don't know, dude. Everyone's telling me that I sound fine. Then you got some people saying they can't hear me, so it must be on your fucking end.
Everybody reboot, come back. Anyway, back to Jake Paul. So when all the Viners left, they went over to YouTube, and then that's why we have this mess known as Jake Paul right now.
Yeah, but like, so that's what he was. He was a Viner.
Yeah, dude, he was a huge Viner. Huge Viner. And then now he's just making really shitty vlogs.
Well, I mean,
Seen his views? I mean, I can't hate on the dude is crushing views, dude. Crushing.
He's making millions.
A month. Millions. A month. Not even a year. A month. A month, dude. So, dude, he's getting like 6 to 8 mil a video, and he's dropping daily, sometimes twice a day, dude.
Should I start trying to impress 8-year-olds?
Well, I mean, if you want to be Jake Paul.
I do. I strive.
If you want to be Jake Paul, I mean, all you got to do is dab on them haters and make really. Dude, did you listen to his rap song?
Who the fuck says dab, man?
No, please tell me you listened to his rap song. No, it's every day, bro.
I'll ask you guys this. What does dab mean?
It's like when someone tries to shake your hand and you blow them off. It's like stupid. Like, it's like something like a 5-year-old would do.
But, dude, no, seriously. Did you guys listen to his song? It's hilarious. Like, that's where all the memes come from.
Is that the one where he was talking shit on Keemstar?
You mean PewDiePie?
Was it PewDiePie?
The song starts off with like white boy, and then he's like da 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 with that Disney Channel flow, and then like instead of saying fucking, he says flipping, And then you got the British dude who's like, England is my city. And he's like, no, I'm not from Compton. It's like, dude, you're a fat white British guy. We know you're not from Compton. And hang then, and then
I just want to reconnect, dude, because maybe like, you know.
All right, reconnect. It's all on him, guys.
Yeah, but what the fuck was I saying? So dabbing is like what, like, yeah, it's the equivalency of like a fucking fidget spinner. It's stupid. It's just like what 3-year-olds.
There's video of you playing with a fidget spinner.
I believe you bought that for me, though.
No, I have it at my house right here. You played with my fidget spinner for 30 minutes. I thought it was going to last for like 45 seconds, and you just kept playing with it. It was hilarious.
They're fucking, I don't know, man. I'm exposed.
You bought one, didn't you? You bought, no, actually, one of your, there was a person on the trip with us that bought one. I bet you stole theirs.
Yeah, I did.
I knew it!
I'm not gonna lie, dude. Like, I'm not gonna lie, but, what was I fucking saying? I'm not into this whole impressing 8-year-old fucking saga. I'm just not into it. Like, how to be a YouTuber 101. Do something to impress 7-year-old children. Like, dude, I'm just not into that fucking shit, man. I'm not into that shit. But that's what Jake Paul seems to be. And, like, that's where the millions are. But I don't have the, I just can't do it, dude. I can't do it. I mean, should I like, should we call this the 8-year-old, please?
Well, no, we would never make it because here's the thing, you can't curse. Like, you gotta say flippin', dude. We wouldn't make it an hour without saying the word fuck.
Like, we don't. I don't ever. When do I fucking? When do I cuss, dude?
See, that's why we could never be Jake Paul, man.
Well, Disney kicked him out. Disney fired that bitch ass.
Well, he won't admit it, but yeah, they fired PewDiePie too. Firing everybody, dude.
PewDiePie's a multimillionaire. You think he gives a fuck?
You think Jake Paul gives a fuck?
No, he's a millionaire.
Dude, he's got Lambos and shit. He's done. He doesn't care. That's why he's like tearing down his house, man. Like, he's got so much money.
He should buy some class.
Dude, you can't buy class. You either
You can. Well, you might not be able to buy class, but you can buy Twitter verifications.
Really? Can you tell us about that?
I mean, so well, actually, T has to announce it because, like, T has to do the breaking news announcement. So go ahead, T.
Shit, what am I announcing?
I want you to say this, T. Breaking news!
Breaking news.
So it's been brought to our attention now that you can purchase a Twitter verification. And that's confirmed. You can go to fucking Google and you can purchase a Twitter verification like anybody can. So if you want your channel verified, you can go on Google, type in Twitter verification purchase, and the steps will be in there and you can buy a Twitter verification. So, and I believe, who's that fucking person that's suing me all the time?
Which one?
Which what? The guy runs a show doing fake shark card giveaways. Fuck is his name? Hef or some shit. Hey guys, what's up? And in today's videos, we're gonna talk about how to get $30 trillion by just doing nothing and without any further ado. I'm gonna reply to all of Hagy's tweets. Because I'm a 16-year-old virgin boy, and I'm going to stalk a grown adult because that's what I do. And if they ever reply to me, I'm going to email them 35 times a day and say that my allowance was upped and I can hire Melanie again. So without any further ado, and with that being said, Melanie is back on the payroll. And with that being said, and without any further ado, you will be getting your papers in the fucking mail.
Okay, I can't do it. Oh my god, dude. I mean, would now be a good time for you to make that phone call you were talking about?
Oh, so get this. T, can you please do me a favor and say breaking news?
Breaking news.
All right, so I don't know. I mean, like, dude, do they even want, I mean, let me ask you guys watching, do you guys want me to fucking call, do you guys want me to call my like real lawyer and talk to him about.
Fuck yeah.
All right, talk for a minute while I piss. When I come back, I'm going to call, like, a real lawyer presented me before when I got a DUI. Which, how comes they never exposed my DUI?
That's weird. I'm surprised that that one didn't get exposed.
Like, it's public knowledge, dude, because we were talking about this shit at work the other day, and we looked it up, and it's still there. And I'm like, God damn. Well, it hasn't been. I don't know if it's 7 years or 10 years, but it hasn't. It's only been. It was 2014, so it's only been 3 years, but.
Shame on you for drinking and driving, Jeffrey.
I'll explain, like, what happened.
That'd be a great story. I'm sure everyone would love to hear how you got a DUI.
I'll explain it when I get back.
I'm sure it wasn't your fault.
Imagine all the people that are going to be spending their time tonight looking that up, Googling it, and trying
to... Oh, I guarantee you right now, dude. I guarantee you people are looking it up right now.
Oh, yeah, they're typing it in the Google right now. They're searching...
I mean, but if they just wait, they'll get the whole, you know, story. Let's see. T, anything you want to talk about?
Shit, I don't know. What are you drinking tonight there? I'll ask you that.
That's a silly question, T, and you know that.
Still drinking that nasty Corona stuff?
You can hate on me all day long, but you know what? I really don't care. Because it is delicious, it makes me happy, and it makes me drunk. Therefore, it is good, and it does not make me feel like shit in the morning.
Well, I guess you got a good point there. I can't argue with that.
I mean, dude, do you think that I just drink the shit for shits and giggles? Like, do you think I drink it to be like Larry? I mean, come on now. Like, let's think about this logically.
Honestly, that's what I thought. Larry again on his good side. Be like, hey, look at me, Larry. I'm drinking Corona just like you.
I mean, I should have been a mole. I should have been like, dude, I love Corona. Like, let's do some collab videos. Let's, you know, but he blocked me on Twitter, so that can't happen anymore. Pretty sad. Pretty sad. Anyway, I can make the stream louder, please. Hold on.
Yeah, like, it sounds good on the Discord end, but for some reason on the YouTube end...
Is everything on the YouTube end low?
For me, it is, yeah.
Like, everybody's voice.
I can have, like, I got my YouTube full blast. It's playing in the background. I can't even hear it over, like...
Alright, hold on. Let me see what I can do.
Yeah, like, I'd say it's probably about a quarter of the volume of what the disc...
That's weird, because it's not like I changed anything crazy.
Alright, so I'm back. Now, remember, you know how, like, when we were at the beach and we were getting all liquored up?
Yeah.
We'd be like, hey, we need this or we need that, we'd go get it.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is there's a difference between being drunk and being... legally intoxicated. You see what I'm saying?
I mean,
like, you can drink fucking 100 beers and be fucking blah, 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 and you shouldn't even be walking down the street. Or you can be like drunk but feel fine and be able to operate a motor vehicle. You see what I'm saying?
I mean, I feel you.
Like, you can feel fine.
Oh,
like, you...
Jesus Christ, hold on. Don't say anything. Don't say anything. I just fixed the audio problem. Hold on.
Don't say anything.
Yeah. The audio problem. Okay, turn all your shit back down. Turn all your shit back down to the place it was. Actually, hold on. No, I just figured out a way to fix it. It wasn't really a problem. It was just being a bitch. Go ahead. Say something.
Hi.
Oh, Jesus. Maybe that... All right, say something. All right, I think we're going to be all right now. I'm trying to fucking fix it.
Some people are saying we sound perfect. Shit, some are saying we sound great. So I don't know what the fuck to say.
Alright, just keep talking. Tell your story. I'm going to keep playing with it. Eventually I'll figure it out.
They can't hear me at all, so why would I tell a story?
No, they should be able to hear. There's no way they can't hear you. That's a lie.
Yeah, but people that I know that are cool, like, wouldn't lie. Like Lee Silver and Kirby.
All right, give them 5 seconds. Give them 5 seconds. Now it's good. 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 Now it's good.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Okay. I don't know what the fuck. For some reason, no, I know what it was. Discord updated, and Discord fucked me in the ass is what happened.
They make you humble?
No, they didn't make me humble. They just fucked me in the ass and didn't make me humble. They fucked me in the ass and pissed me the fuck off. Now continue your fucking story.
All right, so what I'm saying is, so, like, I don't know. Have you ever been to the point where, yeah, you're drunk, right? But you can be like, yo, I could drive to fucking Mexico if I needed to. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, we all do that. Like, you know, but according to the law, if you drink, like, I don't even know, like, what is it, like, four? If you drink, like, 3 or 4 beers, you're fucking hammered.
Well, technically, right? Buzz driving is illegal.
Yeah, I mean, I look, I'm not here. I'm not debate the law. Like, I know what the law is. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know. I'm not trying to debate the law.
Right.
But what I'm saying is, I know my capabilities, and I know what I can and what I can't do. Like, I know that. So, what I'm saying is, one time, maybe like 4 years ago, I don't even know when it was, dude. I think it was it was 13 or 14. Hell, it might even have been 12, but I think it was 13. So, a bunch of us, there was 4 of us that went to Atlantic City on a Friday night, right? Drove all the fuck way to Atlantic City and shit. And, you know, we gambled, did whatever we did, whatever. And it was like 3 in the fucking morning when we were like, yo, let's go home. And my one buddy was like, let's get a hotel room. And I'm like, dude, you ain't getting a hotel room on a Friday night at 3 in the morning without, you know, without making reservations. And my buddy was like, well, dude, we're all fucking hammered. And I'm like, I'm good. I'll drive. I don't give a fuck. I'll drive. And they were like, dude, you were doing shots. You were doing this. I'm like, dude, I'm fine. It's 3 in the fucking morning. We just ate. I haven't drank in like fucking 3 hours. I'm fine. And they were like, yeah, but if we get pulled over, you're fucked. And I'm like, we're not going to get pulled over. I'm fine. Like, I'm seriously fine. So we're fucking driving, right? And from my house to Atlantic City is about, I'd say like 3 hours, maybe 3 hours, I guess. I don't know. Dude, get this fucking shit. So we get like, it was probably, I'd say 15 minutes away, right? And here's what happened. I went through the fucking, the Easy Pass turnpike shit.
Right.
And for whatever goddamn motherfucking, fuck the Easy Pass. That motherfuckers fucked me in the ass on that shit. So for whatever reason, and I know what happened. So you know how, like, when your credit card expires, they send you a new one.
Yeah.
But all the numbers and shit are changed, or the expiration date, whatever. So my Easy Pass, my credit card got updated. So Easy Pass tried to bill it and it got denied. So they shut my Easy Pass off. All right. So coming home, we didn't go through Easy Pass going down, but coming home, I tried to get the quickest route possible. So we went through Easy Pass, and like, the light was red, dude, but I went through it anyway. I'm like, I don't know, fuck it, I have Easy Pass, whatever. And the 2 guys in the back seat were sleeping, and my buddy in the front seat was like, dude, it was red. And I'm like, I don't give a fuck if it was red. I got Easy Pass. It's fucking registered, whatever. So, you know, we get on the turnpike, and like, dude, within a mile, we get pulled over by state fucking troopers and shit. And I'm like, oh, Christ, here we fucking go. And you can drink all fucking day and be stone cold sober on the market, and they're still going to smell the shit, right?
Yeah.
So by now it's like 5, it's like 6 a.m., like 5:30, 6 a.m., and we get pulled over by these fucking state troopers and shit. And they come up to my car and they're like, blah, 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 you know, registration, all that bullshit. And I gave it to them. And like I told you, I wasn't fucking drunk. I wasn't stuttering. I wasn't fucking, you know what I mean? I was fine. And they're like, where are you coming from? And now the problem is, and my buddies bust my balls about this still, the problem is that me being me and a smart ass. They were like, where are you coming from? And I said, back there. That wasn't the answer they wanted and shit. They were like, what do you mean? Where were you at? And I'm like, that's irrelevant. Like, what's up? And they were like, well, your Easy Pass, you blew a toll. And I'm like, yeah, I noticed it was red, but you know, something's wrong with my Easy Pass, fucked up or some shit. And he says, how much you had to drink tonight? And I said, I haven't had nothing to drink since about 11 p.m. And that was the honest to God truth. And he says, well, where were you guys at? And I'm like, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter where we're at, where we're coming from. That's irrelevant to you. What's going on? And he says, well, the reason I pulled you over is because you blew through a toll. And I said, well, I didn't blow through it. Like, I didn't blow through the motherfucker. I stopped. didn't register, and I kept going. And he says, all right, how much you had to drink? And I said, again, I haven't drank anything since, 11 o'clock. It's now, 6 o'clock in the morning. So he says, will you take a breathalyzer? And I'm like, of course. Because if you in Pennsylvania, if you refuse a breathalyzer, you lose your license right away. And I'm like,
oh.
So I took one, dude. So the legal limit's 0.08. You know what I blew?
What?
0.08. Yeah, dude. And I'm like, oh, my God. So my buddy in the back seat wakes up, and I'm like, hey, and the cop was really, I'm not going to sit here and talk shit about cops because he was really cool. He's like, can anybody in this car drive? And I was like, fuck no. I didn't say that. I was like, yeah. I was like, my boy in the back seat can drive. So, dude, my man breathalyzed all of us, dude, and every fucking one of us blew a .08.
Dude, except, that thing was fucked up.
Except for my man in the back seat blew like a 1 point or a .1. he was like just over by a little bit, and he's like, I ain't driving anyway, fuck it. So the cop's like, well, you're under arrest for DUI. And I'm like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. You're gonna give me a fucking DUI for blowing the legal limit. And he's like, yeah, the legal limit's .08. You blew a .08, so that's not legal. And I'm like, what the fuck? So now I start getting fucking now I start getting fucking belligerent and shit, And I started going off about Barack Obama and fucking I start going off about fucking Barack Obama's health care and all kinds of shit. And this fucking cop, dude, he told me at least 10 times if I knew it was good for me, I'd shut up. And then I started talking about, that I was his boss and I pay his salary and you're fucking fired. And I wasn't even drunk. I was just upset. And I'm like, you know what? You're fucking fired. And he's like, yeah, if you would just, if you knew what's good for you, you'd shut up. And I'm like, no, you shut up. I'm your boss. So he puts me in the back of the fucking car, dude. And I had to, I don't even want to say this on the air. I'm going to skip that part.
Nah. Oh, come on. It can't be that bad.
I pissed my pants in the back of a cop car. it wasn't like bad. I had to piss. And I told him, can I piss along the road? And he's like, no. And I'm like, well, I've been doing it the whole fucking way home. And then he tried to say he was going to give me a disorderly conduct for that. And I'm like, well, you can't prove it, though. And he's like, but you said you were doing it. And I'm like, okay, I killed Kennedy. I killed fucking Kennedy. And I'm like, arrest me for that, bitch. And my buddies are like, dude, shut the fuck up. And I'm like, nah, fuck these fucking pig fucks. I killed fucking Kennedy and I killed Lincoln. Dude, I started fucking going off. And I wasn't even drunk, like I said, but I started fucking going off, dude. I'm like, get me for murder, motherfucker. I killed Kennedy. I killed fucking Kennedy. And so this fucking, this young fucking state trooper, he's like, sir, it's a felony to threaten the president. And I'm like, what are you talking about? I ain't threatening nobody. I'm telling you, I killed Kennedy. Dude, it was a fucking okay, so they wouldn't let me piss, right? So I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to piss, in my pants. So I started doing that. I didn't piss a lot. I just pissed, barely any. And then I'm like, I didn't want to do it anymore because I'm like, fuck that shit. I know I'm going to jail. I'm not trying to get ass raped and then have pissy pants all over my fucking self. So, and I'll tell you what, the last fucking thing I wanted to do was call my old man. And Tyndall, you met my old man. And
yeah.
My dad always told me, I'll do anything for you. I'll always be there for you. But if you ever call me from jail, call someone else. And I'm like, all right. He's like, you put yourself in that situation, don't call me.
Your dad is not the one that I would want to have to call from jail.
especially at 5:30 in the fucking on a Saturday morning. Pops.
Oh, God.
This newspaper and shit,
Dude, he's going to show up with a cigar and put it out in your face.
Well, dude, when I used to work night shift, dude, a lot of times I'd go over to my parents' house in the morning for breakfast. And I got off when I worked night shift, I got off at 5 a.m., which would put me in my parents' house by 5:15, 5:20. And my dad was just getting up And he would, dude, he would always have his coffee and his paper. And, dude, you didn't, you saw at the beach. You didn't bother. you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You let him watch his news, and then you talk to him. But you don't interrupt the man's news.
He's set in his ways. Like, you gotta learn to get along with him.
Yeah, so this cop was like, all right, well, you're going to jail for DUI. And I'm like, fucking take me to goddamn jail. I don't give a fuck. Like, nothing I can do to talk my way out of this. Take me to motherfucking jail, whatever, whatever. So we go to fucking jail. And it's weird, like, rolling up to jail at fucking 7 a.m. on a Saturday, dude. Like, it's weird as fuck, you know? So they put you in there and shit and all this bullshit. And, of course, you can't get a judge until Monday morning, which that was the fucked up part. So they were like, you want to call your lawyer or whatever? And I'm like, yeah. But anyway, that's my DUI story. And my lawyer, who I'm about to call, I don't want to say that he didn't really, like, it cost me, the DUI cost me 10 grand. So I probably helped pay for his kid's tuition. But I'm going to give him a call. To hell with it. You guys want me to call him? If you want me to call my lawyer, type one in the chat, and I'll fucking do it.
You know they want it. I got to take a piss real quick.
Go piss. I'm going to call my fucking lawyer. I just want to ask him some questions about, like,
all those ones.
Well, yeah. Wow. Holy fuck. I just want to ask him, you know, like, the legalities of saying you're a lawyer when you're not and threatening to sue people. I know it's illegal. But, you know, Hef Proporial is listening. So before I go to the next step, I'm going to call an actual fucking lawyer and just, I don't even know why. Like, whatever. So I'm going to do it right now.
It'll be interesting to hear what an actual lawyer has to say about it.
Like, you know, a real lawyer, like, not a made blow-up doll. So I'm going to call him right now. Here, I'm going to call him right now. Put it on speaker. Hey, Bill, it's Jeff Hagy.
Jeff Hagy.
You remember me?
I believe so. Okay.
Yeah, I texted you earlier and asked if I could call you.
Oh, all right. Yep, I remember now. How's it going, Mr. Hagy?
You can call me Jeff, but it's cool. How you been, man?
I'm signing out this paperwork I gotta take care of.
I'm not in any trouble. I just asked you a few questions, if you didn't mind.
Oh, that's fine with me.
So, can you tell me, like, the legal, like, okay, let's say that I don't like somebody, and I threaten to sue them and tell them I'm a lawyer. Like, what's the law? Like, is it illegal to tell someone you're a lawyer when you're not?
Well, it depends. If you're going to actually, I don't know if it's necessarily illegal. But it depends on if you're actually going to go to court and file paperwork under a lawyer. If you're going to go to court and say that you are representing yourself as a lawyer, then yes.
So
the states, they differ.
So if I know you can represent yourself, like, I know that. But to tell somebody you're a lawyer, is that illegal?
Yes.
Oh, it is. Okay. Well, let me tell you, there's a little 16-year-old boy that keeps saying he's going to sue me and shit. Now, I don't want to get you off on the wrong track here. He never said he was a lawyer personally, but he made a fake believe, like, Fugazi, I'm sorry, a fake lawyer named Melanie who doesn't exist. And now here's the deal. Here's what I wanted to ask you. So when you helped me with my DUI, If the other party wanted to contact you, you would have to legally give them all your contact information, correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, so I asked for this lawyer's name, and they refused to give it to me. I asked for her law firm's name. They refused to give it to me. I asked for contact information. They refused to give it to me. I asked for a phone number, anything. They refused to give it to me. Now, what I'm told is, if I want to talk to his lawyer, I have to contact him. Now, have you ever heard anything so stupid?
Well, has he filed any sort of legal documents, any court papers, anything?
Have I? No, I haven't done anything. I just what I'm being told is. Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead. What?
Has he filed any type of charges?
No. He just keeps saying he's going to, but he never does. He keeps telling me I'm going to get letters in the mail, and I never get them. And then when I question, like, where's my letter? He says, oh, it got returned because you refused to see. He makes up shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So what do I, what I'm asking you is, like, what do I do?
Well, what I could do for you is I could, if you give me the information, I can take it out to the court, and we could do a counter sue for harassment.
Well, what am I going to get out of suing? Like, who do I sue, though? His parents? Like, who do I sue?
You would sue the individual that is harassing you.
Okay, but
this person is saying that he has lawyers and everything, and there's no reason why he has to hide the information.
That's what I'm saying. So do we sue his parents, or do we actually sue him, and then his parents would, you know...
Well, we'd have to... in 16. I'd have to look into that. I would assume we'd have to go after his parents.
All right. Can you... I mean, obviously, you're going to... This is going to cost me money now. Now, I know his parents are loaded, but can we go ahead and get this on the roll? Can we get this going? Because, like, dude, I'm just... Like, I'm sorry to call you dude. Like, I'm tired of it. Like, this is every day, 5, 10, 15 emails that he's suing me, and I'm like, that's fine, then do it. But it constitutes harassment now, so can we just go after, like, his guardian?
Yeah, the way you sound, it is.
Okay, well, can you put that in motion? I mean, what do you need from me?
All I need, you still have my email, correct?
Yeah, I have all your info, yeah.
Okay. Send me everything you have on the individual.
Like, should I send...
Numbers, everything. If you have any emails or anything, I suggest you keep that.
Yeah, I have every email he's ever sent me. Those two?
Yeah, we can print those out. We can present them to the judge, and that will make a strong case against harassment.
Okay. So, should I call you Monday morning, or, you know, I know it's Friday night.
Can you call Monday morning, say about 10 a.m. work for you?
Could you make it like 11? That's when I take my lunch break.
11?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be all right.
Okay, I can do that. I'll call you Monday at 11.
All right, just make sure you send me that stuff through email first.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Get everything going.
I'll do it tonight after.
When we talk Monday, I'll let you know what has been done.
All right, thanks a lot, sir, and I appreciate it. And I will do all that tonight or tomorrow morning, and I will give you a call Monday.
All right, sounds good to me.
All right, thanks a lot, sir.
No problem.
All right, bye. Okay, so that's that's how you deal with, like...
Wow.
Now, obviously, I'm not going to fucking, you know what I mean? Like, I'm going to, okay, what do I do? What do I do?
Nah, you do it. You do it because I'm sick of it. Just do it. Fuck it. I'm so sick of it. Just do it.
But here's the deal, dude. Like, to me, it's entertainment. Like, and I was 16 once. And without any further ado, like, you know what I mean? Like, dude, but I'm just, I'm tired of it. Like,
honestly, doing him a favor because this will get his parents to pay attention to him.
And I tried calling his fucking parents. They don't give a fuck. Well, now they're going to have to give a fuck. You know what I mean? So, like, dude, I just don't want to waste money on this motherfucker, dude, because this ain't going to be fucking free. I mean,
win the case, his parents pay for it.
Well, yeah, like, if I sue him for slander, I can get, like, what, $500 out
no,
of it?
You sue it. No, you sue him for harassment, dude. That's a much bigger charge.
Yeah, but it's civil, so it'd be, like, $5,000. Well, I'd take $5,000.
$5,000 plus lawyer fees.
Yeah, okay, all right.
So, well, $5,000, dude, that's cool. 5 G's, man. That'll teach him to leave people alone.
He sounded all pissed off.
I'll send you everything I have, too, dude. I'll make sure. I'll send you everything
actually,
I got.
No, because don't do that, because it doesn't really involve you. Like, I'm not going to sue him on your behalf.
That's true.
I'm going to sue him for what he's done to me, not you. So, I mean, if you want to, dude, like, if you want to fucking do it, too, that's...
If your lawsuit works out, I may sue him. I do know a lot of lawyers, and if I could get $5,000, I mean, it's $5,000.
5 grand is 5 fucking grand.
So I wonder if your lawyer actually contacted him, would he get a response from Melanie?
Well, that's the deal. Like, you know, and everybody knows it's bullshit. Everybody. And that's what I'm tired of. Like, everybody knows it's bullshit. And I don't mind, like, people saying they're going to sue me. That's fine. But when I ask for your lawyer's info so I can talk to her about this, and you tell me, no, you can't have it. Come on, man. You're making yourself look more fucking dumb. So now I'm sitting here the other night thinking, like, dude, how can I just get this to go away? Should I call my lawyer who defended me for, how long ago was it? 3, 4, 5, whatever the fuck it was. Should I just call him and tell him what's up? Well, why not? But I never did tell you guys the outcome of that DUI case. So here it turns out that the breathalyzer machine that they hit me with wasn't calibrated for like 19 months.
Knew it.
Oh, you did? Did I tell you that at the beach?
No, but I knew it because, like, it was hitting everybody with a .08.
Oh, yeah. So
I could tell by the numbers it was reading off that something wasn't right.
Yeah, I figured the same thing.
Yeah, but it still cost me, like, fucking 10 grand.
Though. Well, that sucks, but still, you got lucky because I'm assuming you didn't go to jail.
Well, I did go to jail for one night. Oh, well, no, yeah. I lie. It was 2 nights. I went to jail Friday. No, I went to jail Saturday morning and got out Sunday morning because they brought in some kind of judge who let me out on my own recognizance, pending that I would show up for court. So I called this lawyer who was recommended. The guy we just talked to, I called him, recommended by a buddy. And he was like, so there was four of you in the car, blew a .08. And I said, no, the one guy blew a .1 or some shit. So they subpoenaed the calibration records for this breathalyzer that they used, and it was 19. I don't want to lie. It might have been 9 months, but I think it was 19 months.
I should have been a lawyer, dude. If I picked up on that right away and that's what won the case, dude, I missed my calling.
It wasn't a win or a loss. It was you're guilty, but we fucked up kind of deal. Like, because
that didn't get you off on a technicality.
Well, here's the deal. Like, the way I explained it, I was like, because the thing that got me was I admitted to, like, it was on video, dude. You know how they record everything? Like, I was drinking until 11 p.m. and this was 7 hours later. That's what fucked me, because they were like, well, you were drinking, but you're like a big dude and you ate dinner and you quit drinking. So legally you may have been drunk. And then my lawyer was like, we're not talking about may have, may not be. We're talking about, was he drunk? And you didn't have the equipment to test that. And they never took blood either. They never fucking took blood, which is where they fucked up. So when I got to jail, they were going to take blood, dude, and get this fucking shit. They didn't have any needles. I'm dead fucking serious. They were like, yeah, we don't have any needles. We're going to take blood tomorrow. And then when I called my lawyer, he came in there and he's like, no, you're not taking blood tomorrow. You're taking blood now. You can't take blood 24 hours later. You take it now. You know what I mean? And my lawyer, this motherfucker went Sal Goodman on their ass. He was like, so while he's sleeping, you're going to dump vodka down his mouth and then take his blood? No, we're not having that. He's like, oh, wow. Now, of course, I'm not going to do that. But he was a junkyard dog. And he was like, no, you're going to take blood now, or you're not going to take blood. That's how it's going to be. And they were like, okay. And plus, dude, they never let me call. Like, they didn't let me call. It was just, the whole fucking situation was fucked up. Like, they threw me in there, and I'm like, yeah, I want to make my phone call. And they're like, you'll make your phone call when we allow you to. And I'm like, what the fuck? Oh, and the biggest fucking thing that contributed to this whole fucking thing was that they never read me my rights. That was the biggest fucking thing.
Wait, that should have thrown out the entire thing.
Well, I'm getting to that, but my lawyer was like, well, see, here's the deal. They didn't remember my rights, but they told me that they're sure I know them. And that's when my lawyer said, like, that's harassment. So you're saying my client, who has no history of being in any kind of trouble, knows his rights? What does that mean? So after about 45 minutes, the judge said, okay, this case is over with. You're free to go. And the reason I said that I'm guilty but not guilty is because it still cost me 10 fucking grand. You see what I'm saying?
That's crazy.
That's completely illegal. Yeah, it is illegal. And but dude, the cops do so much fucking illegal shit is what I'm getting at. But anyway, that's why this dude is pretty cool. But dude, he's a lawyer. They're all crooked. I hope he's not listening anymore. I don't even think that he was, to be honest with you. I don't think he was listening at all, to be honest with you. But they're all fucking crooked. And the machine was 9 or 19 months out of date. I was never read my rights. Dude, it was just a bunch of fucking bullshit. And that's why it was dismissed. But in my mind, I'm like, oh, shit, I'm free. And then the lawyer bill comes, and it's like, oh, yeah, I got to pay that still. You know what I mean? Because if, you know, if I didn't have a fucking lawyer, dude, I was fucked. You know, if I would have represented myself, I was fucked. I wouldn't know to ask about calibrations and all that fucking bullshit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you got to. In situations like that, you have to have a lawyer.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, yeah. And they're not cheap, dude. You know, they're not cheap, so.
Yeah.
Anyway. So we're going to take our first fucking break here, and I want to thank everybody. And once again, our sponsor, VapeRight.org. If you're into that vaping, go to VapeRight.org, check them out. But we're going to take our first break, and we'll be right back. So, Tyndall, cut that shit.
You mean turn that shit on?
We'll see.
Well, is everybody, T, are you taking a break too?
Yeah, I gotta fill up my drink here too, actually.
All right, we'll be right back, guys.
Thank you.
Is anybody back yet?
Yeah, I'm back.
I was playing like some really like grindy music that's probably annoying some people.
I was into the music. I liked it.
Did you hear this one?
I was digging it, dude. It reminded me of, you know, the movie Scarface for some fucking reason. I don't know why, but it just did.
Well, did you hear like the heavier music after the trippy music?
Honestly, I only heard the last like 15 seconds because I was out making a drink.
Oh, okay, it's all good. All right, yeah. Well, I guess we are back now.
All right, so next topic. Oh wait, I gotta mute the fucking shit. What the fuck? Oh no, we're good. We're good. Anyway, dude, I wanted to say something, and I fucking forgot what it was.
Should have wrote it on your whiteboard.
Yeah, dude. Yeah.
That's for during the fucking week. T, what are you drinking tonight? Why the hell do I hear you guys when my shit's... Oh, there we go. So, should we get into the Larry's Lounge shit, or...
I think so, because... Well, I mean, like, do prank calls take calls? What are you talking about?
Let me see if anybody's in the fucking shit over there. There's not really anyone. My boy After Arts is in there, but he's muted. And After Arts, he did all my intros, dude. Like when I first started YouTube, he did all my fucking intros. But yeah, he's cool, dude. But he's muted. I'm not gonna bring it. And then some other dude named Christopher.
We should just move to the next topic because there's a lot to say about Larry.
All right. Well, I mean, I would like to do one call.
Okay, we'll do a call.
Should I bring Peter out?
No, I think you need to do something fresh. I want something fresh, something hot. Fresh and hot.
I was going to call a gay bar as a gay man.
That's completely not fresh, not hot, overdone.
When have I ever done that?
Every week that you do Peter.
Dude, at my Bill Oxford, I don't remember that fucking character.
That's why I said Bill Oxford, because I don't remember him either.
Yeah, I don't.
When's the last time we brought Peter out? I can't even remember.
No, it wasn't that long ago. It was like no more than a month. No, we need to push him. He needs to step it up.
I don't know who Bill Oxford is, man. OG Bobby Watts. I think I remember.
All right, do OG Bobby Watts. That's fair enough.
Who do I call, though?
OG Bobby. I don't. Dude, look. Do a throwback and sell some stones. That's fine.
That's fugazi. That's played out.
All right. Well, then, I don't know, dude. What would OG Bobby Watts do?
Let me call a gay bar, please.
Just call a gay bar. As OG Bobby Watts.
I don't remember that fucking guy. How do I do it?
All you know anymore is Peter. Guys, please help him. Everybody spam him with his character descriptions. You got Haran Gahan.
Oh, I'll do him. I'll do him.
There you go. You know, here come the sun.
All right. Hold on. Looking for it now.
And then we'll move into other topics that we have.
All right, I'm going to call. Dude, they always fucking hang up on me, man.
You got to play it better, man. Just hang in there.
I'm going to call a record store and try to sell. Wait, let me try to do the voice real quick. That was my Indian guy, right? I have one record. I want to be selling. Is that it, right?
Yeah. You're good.
Okay. All right. I'm going to call right now. Hang on. Find something.
Here come the sun.
Dude, I remember when we fucked up and called the same place, and they were like, yeah, you guys tried this already.
Oh, no, that was when I was Hank. That was when I was Hank, and he was like, you called about grills, didn't you? And I was like, shit, I did. That was still one of my favorite calls.
Here we go. Record store. You guys hear that?
Yep.
Hello?
How can I help you?
My name, Johan
Gohan, I want to sell. I buy.
Can you speak up? I'm having a hard time hearing you.
Hello, you hearing me?
Yeah, not very well, sir.
You sell a record?
Yes, sir. We sell them records.
I buy a storage unit, you know, at auction, and I want to say it filled with a record. I sell to you.
Who's speaking?
Johan Gohan. Johan Gohan. I sell you a record.
You gotta sing.
They vinyl, they all in plastic wrap. I have Beetle, you know, here come the sun, doo doo dee doo. Here come this. Yeah, here come this.
Bring them on down here.
Well, I have more. One say lead, Zeppelin on it. Communication breakdown. I have a nervous breakdown. You know, lead is the peeling. You buy how much you pay though?
You bring them down here, son. I'll take a look at them.
Well,
I can't stay over the phone. I need to see them.
I don't want to waste my time or your time. And also, one I have.
Listen here, fella. Right now, I got customers in the store here looking to buy.
I have album. It go today. Tom Sawyer, he meet me pride. He go all the way and he say hi, hi. Na 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 na. Let me tell you. It go. Na 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 na. Today, Tom Sawyer, he go down the river. He float all the way, and he go, na 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 na. You hear? You know Tom Sawyer? Rush, I believe, called. Rush, they rushing.
Yeah, sounds good. Bring it down here.
How much you give me, though? You give me...
Bring it in, I'll tell you.
You...
Bring it in here, and I'll tell you how much I'll give for it.
You take,
I'll do it over the phone, though.
You take guns? You buy guns off me?
No, I don't buy no guns.
You hear a song. You hear. Listen now. You hear one song. I have one. I have one song go. We caught in a trap. I cannot walk out, baby, because I love you. Then they have song go. Live in Hawaii. I believe it say, I live on corner, heartbreak, hotel, you drew, drew. I buy. I not waste time. How much you give me, motherfucker?
Now listen here, fella. You ain't gonna cuss me out the hell,
fella. No, I was talking.
In a business establishment, I ain't gonna hear it.
I apologize.
Calling Scooter.
Scooter? Your name is Scooter?
That's right, my name's Scooter.
What kind of faggot name gay is that?
Excuse me?
I say you sound like you suck the cock.
Now listen here, fella. I'm a good Christian man, I ain't gonna listen to that.
Dude, I can't fucking do it, dude. I can't, dude. I thought you guys were bullshit.
No, that was his name.
No, it was not.
He answered and he said, this is Scooter. You can listen back later. Oh my God, I'm dead. I'm a good Christian man. I'm not going to listen to this.
He did not say
I'm dead, dude. I'm dead. I'm dead.
That was Texas, dude. He sounded like a fucking redneck, too.
Was that Texas?
Yeah, I told
oh
you,
my God.
Los Angeles just played out. We called everybody in.
Oh my God, Texas is hilarious. We need to call Texas more often.
Oh my God, oh my God.
Yes, sir, my name is Scooter. It's on my birth certificate. My name's Scooter.
I couldn't think of how the Elvis songs go, though, dude. I couldn't think of how.
Oh my god, dude! You need to do one of the, like. I just wish you could do it as someone else other than Johan Go. Like, I wish you could pull it off as yourself and just see how many songs you could sing.
Should I call him back as me?
No, he'll know. You got to call another Texas record store and be like, because if you do it, like, you get 1 point for each different song you sing, and you got to be, like, trying to describe the records. You just act clueless. And then,
let me call him back as me, as normal. It just as me.
All right. If you think you can pull it off.
Okay. All right. Hang on.
I mean, if you think you can do it, I mean, Scooter's gonna be mad.
Dude, do I get extra points? I mean, like.
Dude, if you get Scooter on the. I can't stop calling him Scooter, man. All
right.
If you get Scooter on the line and
dude,
you.
Dude, honestly, did you say his name was fucking Scooter?
Yeah, it is.
All right, type Scooter in the chat if that motherfucker said his name was Scooter. Just watch. Wait. No, wait. Don't do it yet. Wait. Just wait for the Scooters. I'm telling you, that dude said his name was Scooter. I swear to Christ.
Nah,
he's.
Dude,
look.
You couldn't have said that.
Look.
I'm seeing in the chat, dude. I didn't hear him say that one time.
I heard him, and I was dying laughing when he said his name was Scooter. I was like, what the fuck podunk place did you call where the guy answers and says, this is Scooter? Like, I mean, if you think, look, 1 point if you can keep him on the line after you say a single word. Another point for each song you sing. But you're going to have to come up with, you can't do records again or you're going to insta-fail. You're going to have to come up with a whole new concept.
What do I say?
I don't know, dude. You're the one that wants to call him back. You could call him, I mean, you could call him back and be like, that was my, foreign exchange student.
No. Yeah, okay. I'll tell him I hired an Arab to look through my records. Yeah, that's what I'll do. All
right,
here. I'm going to call him
right. Tell him, goddamn motherfucker, I'm going to beat him with a shotgun.
Shut up. LC
Records, Scooter, how
can
I help you?
Yeah, how you doing? I just had some. How you doing? My name's Jeff, man. How you doing, Scooter?
Good, how are you doing?
I'm good. I just had a. What I do is I buy storage units. I just had somebody call you. I don't know if you hung up on
storage floors.
No. I buy. Yeah, like that. But I'm not on the show or anything. I buy like storage units people didn't pay for, and I hired this Arab Indian guy. I don't know what the fuck he is, but I had him call you, and he said you hung up on him or something. I don't know what happened.
Well, that's the fella that was just on the phone with me a little bit ago.
Yeah,
he kept on blabbing about different type of songs, trying to tell me getting prizes on somebody. Was that you guys?
Well, no, I mean that was him. And then I came in the room, he got a price for it, and he said you got all mad and hung up on him. I'm sorry about that.
Well, I got tired of hearing it. He started cussing up storm at me, and same thing. I'm not gonna repeat what he said, but he was saying stuff I didn't appreciate.
Well, what did he say, sir?
I'm not going to discuss that on the telephone with you.
All right, well,
let it go.
Business I'm trying to run here.
No, I understand.
If you want to sell or you want to buy.
No, I want to sell. Like, I bought a storage unit filled with records, and I told him, you know, can you call a couple places and see if we can sell them? And he said that you hung up on him, you got real smart with him or something. I don't know. But I want to apologize. They're all brand new. Like, some of them are still wrapped up in plastic. Like, they're brand new.
Well, like I said, I can't give you an appraisal over telephone unless you bring it in to me.
All right. I got you.
Put the records in. I can take a look at it and let you know.
Well, obviously, you don't have to get all, like, you seem like you're upset. Like, I'm apologizing to you.
I had one of them fellas on the phone call me up, your friend, whatever his name is.
No, he's an employee. He's
a bunch of stuff to me. I appreciate it.
He's an employee. He's not a.
Tell him you're gonna fire him because you're a good Christian man.
Listen, I'll fire his ass. I'll fire him.
I would if I was you. I'd get rid of him. I'm the only one here today.
Well,
I've had to deal with it all day. I'm not doing it no more.
Sir, I'm sorry, Scooter. He cleans out my storage units. That's what he does. He cleans out my storage units I buy. I'm sorry.
People need to be doing.
You're a fucking asshole, dude.
You're a racist.
I'm trying to talk to you, man. I just want to, dude, I'm trying to do you a favor. I want to sell.
What kind of records you trying to get rid of?
Everything he told you I had.
Yeah, I couldn't understand them.
What do you mean?
All I did was sit there singing on the damn telephone with me. Saying he's got this, he's got that, and
was he...
I couldn't understand half the thing he was saying except for the last little bit, and he started cussing at me. Like I said, I'm a good Christian man. I ain't going to listen to it.
Why are you acting like he was actually singing?
Yeah, that sounded like it to me.
What do you
I
mean?
I couldn't understand. The only thing I could hear was him singing.
Like, here comes the sun, do-do-do-do. Was he singing
just
like...
Just like that. Is this the same fella?
No, I'm just asking what he was singing.
Be like he sings that dumb shit all the time.
Well, listen, let me tell you, I pay that fucking guy to mow my grass, and he's always out there fucking singing in the yard and doing stupid shit. Like,
I'll get rid of him.
Yeah, well, I mean,
if he worked here at LC Records, I'd fire him.
So if he walked around your store talking about down on the corner of Heartbreak Hotel. See, I can't sing any else. What's that?
He was in the store?
Yeah, if he came in your store, I'm going to send him in there to talk to you personally.
Yeah, you send him in here.
I will.
We close at 11 o'clock.
Ask him if he'll whip his ass.
Everybody clears out. I want to have a word with him.
Are you threatening physical harm on my employee?
I ain't threatening nobody. I want to have a few words with the young man.
Tell him he doesn't believe in Jesus.
He's not a young man, though. He's 67. You know what they call him?
67.
Well, he's actually 71. He just had a birthday. But you know what they call him?
He sounded like he was 15 years old.
No. He's an old motherfucker. They call him Green Motherfucking Dream. That's what they call him. No. Green motherfucking dream.
I ain't gonna say that. I told you, this is a place of business. I ain't gonna say them kind of words on the telephone.
What if I...
Like I said, I got customers here. I'm not gonna do that.
I don't think you have customers because you're still talking to me.
I don't think you have... I don't think... How many people are in your store right now? How many people?
None of your business.
I got
you. You don't have any customers, do you? Hey. Let me ask you a question, man. Can I ask you a question, though, seriously?
All right.
How much cow shit you got on your boots?
That's it. You're pushing it with me, fella.
No, seriously, how much cow shit?
I love this guy.
Let me ask you something, buddy. You ever,
You let me tell you something, right?
You let me listen.
You call my business up, and you're going to start talking all that stuff.
No, I'm serious, man. You got any farms? You got any farms around you?
Dude, now are you trying to stereotype me or something?
No. I'm asking you if you have any. You ever worked on a farm? Have you ever worked on a farm? I'm just curious.
I don't believe that's any of your business.
You ever got a little curious and wandered into the barn with a sheep or a goat?
Now listen here. I'm married. 14 years, I have 3 children.
Who are you trying to convince?
Did you?
Dude, say it, say it.
I've done a damn good job of it.
Did you almost say, let me listen?
You need to knock this off. I don't know who you think you are calling this place. I'm going to track the number. I'm going to let you all take care of it.
I didn't even block my number. I'm what did I do wrong?
Ask him if
asking you to buy my records.
What's your name?
Jeff.
What's your last name?
Timber.
Jeff Timber.
Yeah. I live with.
I got your number down here on the phone. I'm gonna write it down. And you call here one more time. I'm gonna call the law. I'm gonna give you information.
Call the law for what? Call them for what?
You're harassing me.
I'm asking you to.
You're bothering me.
I'm asking you to buy my. No, I'm not. I'm asking you to buy my records.
I'm not interested.
Okay, thank you, sir. Have a nice day. Hey, you know, oh, you hung up.
Oh my God, dude, that was That was a roller coaster.
You sounded like a real life Hank Hill.
He did.
did.
I swear to God that he almost said, "You let me listen."
I heard it too. He almost did. That was, dude, I'm going to go back and analyze that audio and slow it down, and I'm going to prove that he almost said, "You let me listen."
He was like, "You let me listen." You know what I mean?
Oh, dude, that was one of the best calls that...
Did I call him back?
No, too much. Let it go. He sounds like he's having a rough day. I think he's a closeted gay, dude. He was being a little overcompensative.
Yeah, but when I told him that, when I was like, yo, how many fucking customers you got? He's like, none of your goddamn business.
Everybody wants, like, me to call him back.
All right, well, I'm going to have to give you his number.
I can't, dude. Nah, I don't. No, I feel.
Yo, Tyndall, you're calling as fucking Hank. You're calling as fucking Hank.
What does Hank want with him?
You're going to be an OG gangster. You're going to be an OG gangster.
Oh, my God. All right, dude. All
right, Hank.
Oh, my God.
Let me get the number back. Poor
Scooter. All right, I got to get my shit together. Hold on. Because that was just so damn funny.
Actually, tell him you're looking for some good Christian records to do some...
Yeah, hold on. I got to get a beer real quick, and that'll give him a Scooter minute to calm down. Because Scooter was losing it. Let's let him, like, you know, chill out for a second. I'll be right back. DM me the number.
All right, I will. Wow, T, how'd that sound?
That was pretty good. You know what he said, Scooter? I'm picturing like a Dukes of Hazzard themed.
Scooter. I thought you guys were bullshitting when you said it was a record store. I'm like, no way. I don't know. I think he got kind of offended when I asked the cow shit he had on his fucking boots, dude. That was fucking funny.
Yeah, you know, I'll say he asked him if he ever been on a farm, and he's like, "Oh, I'm not gonna answer that."
No, he said, "Why are you?" He's like, "Why are you stereotyping me?" I'm like, "Nah, have you ever been on a farm?" And I'm like, "You ever got a little curious with a goat or a sheep or anything?" I don't know, dude. He seemed kind of fucking pissed.
I think he hit a nerve or two there, that's for sure.
All right, well, I say that Tyndall calls us Hank. I don't know, man. This is fucking funny, dude. I lost the number.
Oh, shit.
When I close the web page, I gotta find it again. All right, when Tyndall comes back, I'm gonna DM him the number to call. Dude, that was fucking hilarious. I was trying so hard not to laugh, but when I'm like, "What's your name?" and he goes, "Scooter," I'm like,
"Yeah." I was waiting for you to lose it when he said that.
I was trying. Like, did you guys hear me laughing? Because I tried to keep muting my mic. But then I'm trying to talk to this fucking guy, so.
Thing pretty good.
All right, hang on. I got to go to Twitter and give Tyndall the fucking number. If you guys are enjoying the show, type a 42 in the chat. A 42 in the chat for Jackie Robinson if you guys are enjoying the motherfucking show. Last show, T got all fucked up. You guys remember that shit? T was just cussing out everybody. Just cussing everybody the fuck out. That shit was hilarious.
I don't even fucking remember it.
I know you talked to me the next day. You were like, "Yo, Hagy, I'm sorry, man." I'm like, "Sorry for what? You did a fucking amazing job." But I feel bad, like, for fucking... Like, I talked to Green earlier off the air, and I'm like, "Dude, you know, I feel bad that you got to just play whack-a-tard all day." But, hey, he enjoys it. He gets paid to do it, so fuck it. I just, dude, like, when I was trying to, like, when Green and his wife went on vacation, I had to try to watch the fucking retards. Like, dude, I just didn't know who was who. I couldn't fucking keep up, man. It fucking sucked.
All right, I'm back.
I didn't know who was fucking who. Here, I'm gonna DM you the number. I gotta find. I lost it. Hang
on. Yeah, trying to talk with everybody on here, or listen to everybody on here, plus watch the chat. Like, that's
you can't fucking do it, man. You just can't fucking do it.
I know anytime I catch myself looking at the chat, I kind of get lost in it and zone into it. So I try to not look at it just for that reason.
Hang on.
I feel bad for Scooter. Poor Scooter, man.
Hang on, I gotta get the fucking... Oh, wait. Oh, I can just go to my recent calls.
He'll probably tell stories about this night for years.
Why am I looking at the website?
I think it's funny that we called him out for having no one in his store, and he was like, that's none of your business how many people are in my store. I knew he had no one in the store because he kept talking. It's like, dude,
what are you gonna say to him, dude?
I don't know. Do you have any ideas? I was gonna just be like, I was gonna ask for Riff Raff's record.
Yeah, ask him if he sells rap records.
No, I'm just gonna ask for Riff Raff first. He'll be like, "Who's Riff Raff?" And I'm gonna be like, "Hip hop."
Extra points for what? Dude. Extra points if you can sing some Riff Raff song to him.
Let me do something real quick just to make sure.
If you can do Bird on the Wire, like, dude, if you can do any Riff Raff songs,
well, you know I crush Bird on a Wire, like.
I know you do, dude. But if you can do it, if you can do it to Scooter, extra points.
All right, hold on.
Like, you may even get a raise out of that. If you can do it without... Dude, if he hangs up, you lose.
All right, hold on.
There's the number. Like, try to drop that whole fucking verse.
If I... just riffs. Just riffs. Yeah.
The one that you did that riff retweeted us at the beach?
Yeah. I wish I would have got that whole thing in there, man, because I nailed it.
If you can drop, like, a whole entire riff-raff verse, extra points, dude.
All right, I'm going to go for it.
Call this motherfucker. His name's Scooter. I'm gonna mute because I'm gonna fucking crack up.
Yeah, like I'm gonna turn my shit down too, so you guys can't even tell me. You're just gonna have to roll with it.
All right, go ahead. Are you calling?
Hey, how's it going? I was just wondering if you guys had a certain record. I was just wondering before I came through there.
Yeah, what you looking for?
It's by Riff Raff.
Riff Raff, I don't believe I've heard that.
It's like, yo, we 80,000 shopping malls, but we ain't browsing, popping hooded, Transco Towers, prowling, Gucci towels and bathroom vials, nouns, owls, Aston Martin, sparking one in valet parking, lone sharking, hoping that my days with dark and cheetah skin outside the park of propaganda propel us. Ostrich feather security guard with nine Berettas, pulling up Volkswagen Jettas, causing storm and sunny weather and sunny weather and sunny weather, hoping that my days get hoping days get better. Riff. Oh, I'm sorry. Do you know what song I'm talking about?
We don't really have that too many rap music. Is it old? Is it new?
It's new.
Need to sing it again.
No. It's new. It's new-ish. Like 5 years old. But that's pretty old in the rap game.
I don't think we got anything like that here. I mean, you can come by and take a look, but...
I mean, are you guys just running like what? What's your normal records? I mean, what?
We got rock, we got country.
Why?
Not so much on the rap music, just because we don't sell a whole lot of it. But we got some. We got some old stuff.
You got some rap? Because I mean, it kind of sounded like your little race is not having. Do you have R&B? You got R&B?
R&B? Who does that R&B music?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Ask him, man, if he has any ice cube.
Well,
ice
luckily, y'all are a local shop. You get away with this shit. But, man, that's racist, man, that y'all ain't got no rap, no R&B. Do you have jazz?
I said we got rap music.
What rappers you got?
Give me a second here. We got Dr. Dre's.
You got the Chronic?
He said Dr. Dre's.
Damn! I wouldn't expect a good Christian man like you to care the Chronic.
Vanilla Ice.
Who is this?
This is Hank.
Hank?
Yeah, H-A-N-K, Hank.
You're not one of them fellas that been calling here harassing me, are you?
Who are you talking about?
Well, you started off your phone call singing to me. That's what the last two people did.
I did not. I asked you a question, and you asked me how does it go. I sang a bar. Well, I rapped a bar, but you, sir, did ask me.
All right. I ain't going to get no fight on telephone with you.
Is there anything else that I can help you with?
Well, since you do have Dr. Dre, the Chronic, I must say you only half racist. I appreciate your cooperation. Goodbye.
Dude, what the fuck? You hung up already?
Alright, hold on. Alright, I'm back.
Why you hang up on the guy?
Oh, he was about to hang up on me, man.
Nah, he... fuck.
What? Was that not good? I nailed everything.
Yeah, no. It was fucking good, but why you hang up?
See, that Haggy, that's your fault, because he put in the stipulation that if he hangs up, Tyndall loses, so he had
well,
to...
Well, no, he was him. Pissed off because he said that people keep calling him singing, dude. I got to call him again.
Nah, dude. You can't. Leave him alone. Dude, I already nailed him for being racist. He's like, who does R&B music? They have
honestly, no
R&B, no rap.
I went to piss when you did that part. So what did he say?
Oh my god, I thought it was great. Like I thought I'd crushed it. I rapped the whole song. I got.
I heard that. And he was laughing. Then he was like, "You guys keep calling me singing. He knows it's us."
Yeah, but then I started talking to him, and then it took a minute for him to bring up the, are you one of them guys prank calling and harassing me?
Yeah. I heard that part.
See, it's played out now. You gotta, dude, I mean, I know the dude sounds straight up like Hank Hill, but we'll have to save him for another day. I think he's had enough.
He actually sounds like just like a normal Southern motherfucker. Like,
I think he's kind of lonely because he did just let us prank call him 3 times.
What time is it in Texas? Because he's like, we close at 10. It's got to be 10 in
Texas. Oh, hell no, it ain't no 10 in Texas. It's 8:26 Eastern, so it's like 6.
Oh, yeah, they're behind. All right. So
we need to go back onto topics. Yeah, that's enough pranks for now. We'll go back to topic.
That was actually pretty good.
That was like, what, a three-parter? Have we ever had a three-parter? We've done two-part prank
calls. It's hard to call the same... Over.
But that one just flowed because he was down because he was lonely. He was ready to go.
No, I mean, all right. Well, anyway, let's get on this Larry's Loogie type fucking shit.
Yeah,
so,
dude, he wants to talk a lot about you, a lot, without talking to you.
Up. So this bad towel dude left a comment saying, like, Larry, you're a piece of shit, whatever. And Larry went off talking all this shit about me. And it's like, I had nothing to do with it. So anyway, Larry said, and I quote, if Hagy is a man, he would face me man to man. And Green said, well, we'd be one man short, which made me piss my pants because it's true. Anyway, how do I face him man to man when he blocked me? You know what I mean? Like, dude, I would gladly talk to him. He's welcome here. He's been invited multiple times. He's welcome to come on the fucking show.
It would probably be good for his views.
He refuses every time, though. Like, so here's the deal. I mean, is he busy planning his 500,000 subscriber party, or what's he doing? Because, like, I know he was busy planning his million subscriber party, and that went to shit. That went to fucking shit.
You know, I heard he might actually be doing another 100,000 sub party for hits it on his way back down.
I mean, right, when is he just going to stop? I mean, does he have to get under 500K to understand that he should probably just stop?
There's over 100 people here. What I want you guys to do is go to my Twitter and look what I retweeted. And then I can't tweet him because I'm blocked. But if you guys can tweet him and tell him to come on the show, I'll talk to him man to man. Now, what he says is, he's telling me that if I'm a man, I'll come to his house. Okay, first of all, I'm not going to drive to new fucking Jersey just so I can pull into your driveway and you call the cops on me. I'm not going to do that. That's just fucking stupid. You know, I'm not going to come to your house and be arrested, Larry. It's just not going to happen. I'll talk to you on the air right now. I tried to tweet you. You blocked me. I actually never did tweet you, but you blocked me anyway. A lot of our fans, a lot of our listeners tweet you. You block them. What he does is he clicks on my, he just blocks everybody. But if you guys want to retweet what was tweeted earlier, because somebody who listens to us isn't blocked and they tweeted him, I'm sure they're blocked now, but they were like, yo, Larry, Hagy wants to talk to you like a man, like you requested, and you won't allow him. So if you guys want to go to my Twitter and check that out and retweet it, you know, I'll talk to him. Come on in.
I mean, I think that his big deal with you is that you're funny and he's not. And
I think the problem is he was handed a channel with 500,000 subscribers.
But he has no talent. If you have talent, then that's cool. It's like, dude, somebody handed me something. I got talent. I can run with it. But if somebody hands... that's the problem.
Like, his videos are fucking garbage. His channel's garbage. He just sucks. Like,
well, it's like you said, it was handed to him. He doesn't know what to do with it. And Jesse's not helping him no more because he's doing his own thing.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is,
Jesse can barely keep his own fucking channel afloat.
Do you guys see that the only time he gets views is when he says he's quitting YouTube? Like, he's made how many quitting YouTube videos in the last month? 3? And those are the videos that get views. Because everyone's hoping it's true.
I mean, all of his comments are, man, this is cringy. Man, this is cringy. Man, this is cringy. Like, that's his whole comment section.
And think of how many people he's blocked. Like, he must have one of the biggest block lists on YouTube.
Oh, dude, he blocks more people than Hef Purpurials. He blocks more fucking people than Hef Purpurials. But, wait, hold on. I'm getting all these notifications. Yeah, dude, see, everyone's tweeting him now. He ain't gonna fucking... Dude, everyone's fucking
It would help his channel, but you know, I mean,
it probably would. Like, I just, like, here's the deal, and everyone's like, what's your problem with Larry? The problem I have with Larry is all I ever did was say that he was fake when he made that stupid video with the neck brace. That's all I ever did, dude, was say that he was fake. That's all I ever did. And then he made a video saying that I have no talent, I'm a piece of shit, just all kinds of shit. And he didn't like the response he got to that because so many fucking people were telling him he's a piece of shit, he's no better than his nephew, he's garbage. You guys remember that I made him disable his comments, Jeff Tutorial style?
Yeah.
Dude, because of me, he disabled his comments. He disabled his likes, Jeff Tutorial style.
And that went on for like a month.
Yeah, and then he brought it all back because, dude, I only ever said one thing about him. I only made one video about him. And I said, hey, everything he's doing's fake. Then he made a video saying all that shit about me. So I made a recap video, and it got more views than all his shit. And he Jeff Tutorialed his dislikes. He Jeff Tutorialed his comments. And, you know, and he thinks I'm, you know, that's why he hates me. But, dude, what did I say? What did I say about you, Larry, that was wrong? What did I lie about? Like, what did I do to you, dude? I said some truthful things about you and you hate me for it. I didn't harass you at your job. I didn't harass you at your home. I didn't call you. I didn't tweet you. I said you made fake fucking videos. And then you rebutted with some lies. And you got caught up in some lies. You've lost 150,000 subs because of it. Your videos suck. Your channel fucking sucks. And you hate me for it. And you want to talk all kinds of shit, but then you block me. You tell me to talk to you like a man, but I can't because you block me, dumb fuck. And then you tell me to drive to your house. First of all, I'm not as dumb as you, dude. I'm not going to roll up in your fucking driveway, dude, because the first thing you would do is call the fucking law, and you know you would. I guarantee fucking to you if I was like, okay, he's inviting me to his home. Let me go over there. As soon as he saw my car pull into his fucking driveway, dude, I guarantee fucking to you 911. And first of all, I'm not trying to go fight some 73-year-old man. I don't want to fight a 23-year-old man. I don't
want to
fight anybody.
Why does he want to fight? I don't get that.
I have no clue. But, dude, honestly,
why can't you just talk? Like, why can't he just be like, this is my point, and you be like,
300. That guy's fucking, what, 5'8", 120? Like, dude, honestly, dude, I would beat him to a bloody pulp. I don't want to. I'm not a violent person. I don't want to fight no fucking buddy. All I said was you make fake fucking videos and your channel shit. What did I say that was so wrong? What was I lying about? You know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck? He tells me I need to come to his house? I ain't trying to go to your fucking house, dude. Fuck that fucking shit. So I don't know what, you know, I don't know what the fuck, to, you know, no hate needed. No hate needed, just love. I don't know, man. What do you guys think about that?
He's just, he's hurting for views and he knows it.
Oh, he's hurting big time for fucking views. Like, how you gonna be this big time Christian and all you talk about is no hate needed, I'm all about love. And then he flips people off and tells them to go fuck themselves. Like, what kind of Christian does that? It sounds like my man Scooter down there. Well, Scooter was a Christian. Scooter was a Christian. I'll give you that. Scooter was getting pissed off. He didn't want to say fuck. He didn't want to talk about none of that shit, right?
You know what? I can guarantee Scooter would not upload a video of himself flipping people off.
I think Scooter needs to give Larry some lessons in Christianity.
I don't know, man. I don't know. Like I said, dude, I've publicly, openly invited Larry to our show multiple fucking times, and he refuses. But then he wants to talk shit, saying that I won't face him like a man. Well, Larry, I'm not going to come to your house, dude. It's just not going to happen. You want to talk to me as a man? Come on here and talk
to me. Why won't
he
come on here and talk, dude? It's live. We can't bullshit.
He's a fucking pussy.
I mean,
here's the deal. Dude, he's another one of them guys that wants to impress a bunch of 8-year-olds, man. You know, hey, all my ballers, chillers, loungers, and grillers. Who are you talking to, Larry? Your entire audience is under the age of 9. Who are you talking to?
See, and that's why he won't come on, because let's face it, he can sit there all day long and be like, I've got over 500,000 subscribers, but you get less views than fucking Hagy does with 25,000. Who has more influence here, dog?
You know the fucked up shit is, dude, I have 25,000 subs. He has 500,000, and I get more views than him. It's the same. It's the same with Jeff Tutorials, dude. He's got 85,000 subs, and I get more views than him. You guys remember when he tried to do a live stream and he had one watcher? You know what I mean? And then he quickly deleted the shit. He's like, "No, that wasn't me. That wasn't me. It was you, bro. It was you." That's what I'm saying. Like, dude, you can talk shit all you want on me. Number one, I don't give a fuck. Number two, I'm still crushing you in fucking views. And number three, I don't give a fuck. And number four, I don't give a fuck.
He's learning what happens when you get all your subs by fake giveaways rather than actual content.
Oh, yeah. When you do all fake giveaways, nobody ever fucking goddamn wins. So my man Chip Smith just put in the thing. He lost 200,000 subs. Yeah, he did. He was about damn near going to hit 700. And that's when he started hyping up his million subscriber party. Remember that, guys? I don't know if you guys remember that or not.
I remember it.
Well, now he's about to have a 500K subscriber party. And like T said, next month it'll be a 400K subscriber party. And by January, it'll be a 100K subscriber party. So, Larry, give it up, man. Quit. Every other day you're making a video, I'm quitting YouTube. I'm quitting YouTube. Then fucking do it.
And those will get views.
Those are his highest viewed fucking videos. That's fucking sad.
I mean,
anyway.
He's just...
I want to get back into this, but I gotta piss. You want to run a break, or you guys want to keep talking, or what do you want to do?
I don't care.
Let's see, where are we at here? We'll keep talking. It's pretty early.
You know, there's a lot more we have to say, but it's early yet. There's a lot more we have to say. So you want to run a commercial?
Unless T wants to stay here and talk.
Once again, check out vapebright.org for all your vaping needs. You know, if you're into that kind of shit, check them out. Vapebright.org. Check them motherfuckers. And also Billy Goat Potato Chips. Check them motherfuckers out. They ain't paying us yet, but, you know, check them out.
They are delicious.
Anyway, run a break, dude. We'll be back.
Yeah, let's do a break.
Okay, let's...
I have no ice. I have no ice in my cup. Run a break.
Oh, my God. It's such a tragedy, man. Right.
Mad as that be, it's a tragedy. We'll be right back, guys. Hey, are we back?
Hello.
I guess we're not back.
Are we all back?
Yeah, I was in here saying hello.
Oh, okay. My bad.
I'm here.
Alright, so back to what I was fucking. Had to fill my drink up, do a shot, get some ice, whatever. How you gonna fucking talk some shit and be like, talk to me as a man as I block you? Let me hear about that. Let me hear what you guys think about it, because I know I've been doing most of the talking, overriding you two. I want to hear from you guys too. We got the producer, Tyndall fucking. Alright, so it's a new era. Okay, here's how it's gonna fucking go down. This, I wanted to change every fucking thing. All right. Let me explain to you guys what's going on now. Why did I make it the Jeff Hagy Show? Because that's what the fuck it is. All right. Three Sheets Live, I was just not, this is fucking stupid. Like, I was into it, but here's what's happening. So I do pretty much all the fucking talking. Tyndall fucking produces the goddamn show. Tyndall does all the fucking work. Green Dream plays Whack-A-Tard all fucking day. Is that what we're going to call it? Whack-A-Tard? Is that what we're going to fucking call it?
Yeah.
And T, you know, T's a co-host too, just like Tyndall, but T is pretty much like, all right, if you were looking at like the Howard Stern fucking show, you would have Stern. Then you would have Tyndall, who would be like the Gary Delabate, like,
what?
Fooey. And then you would have
Tyndall. I'm funny as fuck, boy. No, I'll shut this saying, motherfucker down right now. Say I'm funny, bitch. Say I'm funny.
I'm not saying you're not. I'm saying that
you're old. Say I'm funny.
You're funny.
Thank you.
And then you have T, who would be like, you know, Robin. And it's all a big part of the fucking show. I'm just trying to explain to the people the roles of the fucking shit. Because, like, Gary does, like, all the shit that y'all don't know about. You know, and then he comes in the show and he talks. He's funny as fuck, whatever. T is kind of like breaking news, whatever. I'm not getting into that. I'm just saying. I wanted to change. Like, here's the deal. I got tired of fucking where it was going, man. I'm sick of being sued every day by fake lawyers. I'm sick of fucking talking about shit that I don't want to talk about. I'm tired of being associated with people who I don't want to be associated with. And I know through talking with everybody off the air, on the air, it's not us. It's you know, the more we ignore people, the more they come at us. And it's like, dude, I'm just like, I was ready to just be done with the fucking shit. I'm just tired of it. Like, you know, I had to go get a fucking lawyer involved. What kind of stupid fucking shit is that? You know what I mean? You can't even have fun anymore. Like, and I told myself, get fucking go. When this fucking shit became unfun to me, I'm done. And when I had 120 subs, 300 subs, 500 subs, 1,000 subs, I said the same fucking thing. I was doing live streams back in the day, and that's when that lion crying piece of shit fucking, what was his name? Boob. That's when he was, I don't want to say he was playing the Green Dream role because he was just dumb. He didn't really know how to do anything. He was just there because I couldn't read the chat. So all he did was, like, I kept him on speakerphone. That's how primitive it was. That's how fucking primitive it was back 3 years ago. I would have Lion Crying Boob on speakerphone, and he would read me questions from the chat because I couldn't figure out how to see the fucking chat and be live at the same fucking time. I just couldn't figure out how to do that. I don't want to say I couldn't figure out how to do it. I just didn't give a fuck. You know, I just didn't care. And that's what we did. It was very fucking primitive, but people liked it. and we would stream to an audience of, you know, what, 20, 25, 30 people. And to me, that was just ecstatic. I was like, wow, there's 30 fucking people watching me. And, you know, we've hit 400 at a time. We've hit 500. We've hit 300. It depends on who's here. And, you know, it depends on who's here. And then I meet a group of people, you know, Tyndall, T, Green Dream. And they all play a different role in this whole fucking thing. Like, Tyndall produces the whole entire fucking show. Tyndall does whatever you see happening, Tyndall fucking does it. And he produces the whole goddamn fucking show. And T makes me fucking laugh. T chimes in when he has to. T gets liquored up, and he makes me laugh, and that's why I keep him around. He chimes in when he has to. And Green Dream does a lot of shit off the air that you guys don't fucking see. Green has brought all the sponsors in. Green brings in all that fucking shit. All the fucking sponsors that we have for this fucking show, Green has brought them in. Green does all the fucking promotional shit for, like, Tyndall's unboxing videos. So all the free shit that we get in the mail, that's Green handles that. So it finally came to a point where I've met a group of people who I want to fuck with. I want to be around. And that's what I want to do. Like, this is, it's still YouTube. It's still, I don't give a fuck, but it's fun to me. So I finally found a group of fucking people that I can associate with, have fun with, and just do this shit with and make it a fucking good time. And yeah, the retards are still going to fucking come in here, still going to be fucking retards. And that's just how it's going to be. And that's why Green does what he does and blocks people. And that's why Tyndall does what he does and produces fucking show. And that's why T does what he does and keeps me fucking happy. And we're going to try to give you guys the best fucking content we can give you. And for everybody asking what happened to fucking 3SL, what happened to fucking 3 Sheets, nothing. It's the same fucking show. I'm just telling you, this is how it's going to be from now on, man. I'm sick and fucking tired of dealing with fucking idiots. I'm just done with it, man. Like, you get fucking to the point where you just don't give a fuck. You just don't care. You know, you get to the point where you're just like, you're fed up with shit. When you get 25 emails a day from a fake fucking lawyer, what do you do? You call a real fucking lawyer. And that's how you handle that shit. Now, am I trying to sue somebody for $14.39? No. But will I spend $2,500 to get some fucking kid's parents to wake up and be parents? Sure, I'll do it. And it looks like that's what I'm doing. And I know this shit ain't going to be fucking free. And why would it be? Now, we'll find out Monday how that's going to go down. And I know it's not going to fucking be cheap, but you know what? Fuck it. To get some fucking virgin loser out of my life and stop this fucking bullshit and stop. I'm just done, man. I'm done with it. I'm so fucking sick and goddamn tired of dealing with fucking retards. I'm tired of it. And we all talked off the air before this fucking show, and I was like, dude, I'm just done, man. It's not even fun to me anymore. Like, some of it is. I'm just fucking tired of it, man. I'm sick of these fucking losers that have no fucking life coming to my fucking show and just go away, man. You don't like me? I don't care. That's fine. I probably don't like you. Go the fuck away. So, I don't know, man. That's where we're going right now, and I just want to do great shows for you guys. And we delivered that. We fucking delivered that. I'm so fucking sick of petty bickering. I'm so fucking sick of people trying to get me to take sides. If you can't get along with us, fuck off. If you badmouth Tyndall, if you badmouth T, if you badmouth Green Dream, go fuck yourself. You're done with me. I'm not going to spend my life arguing with fucking idiots. If you ain't got nothing to say, if you all you want to do is badmouth somebody that's part of my fucking posse, fuck off, man. Go do your own goddamn shit. Motherfuckers always begging me to come to their fucking shows. Hagy, can you come to my show? Hagy, can you do this? Man, fuck them days. Them days are gone. Rotten Tooth ruined that fucking shit. Rotten Tooth ruined that. Tyndall, take over, man. I'm just done with that fucking shit, man. I
100% agree with you. And the whole point of growing the brand and Just in case, like, I know people are going to say shit, but I was 100% behind the decision of changing the name of the show. I just want to support Hagy do his thing, and I'll be doing my thing, too, and we'll just be working together just as collabs do. But, I mean, my role here is not going anywhere. It's not going down any. Nothing's really changing. It's just
there was never a change of scenario.
Yeah, I mean, literally, it's just like we're just making
there was never a change of scenery. It was just, it's hard to explain.
The changes that have been made and will be made will not affect the overall outcome of the show that you guys have come to enjoy every Friday at 7 o'clock. That's not gonna change.
Well, it will get better, actually.
Well, it'll get better, sure. You know, we would like to add more segments, more things that we do, things like that. But any rebranding, any changes of things, anything that sounds different, it's not going to change the core values and the core of what this show does, which is to make people laugh. You know, because, like, most of us, we work jobs, you know, Monday through Friday. You know, we're out there working. We're on our grind. And it's nice to come here on a Friday at 7 o'clock and kick back and have a drink and just have a laugh, you know? For us on the show, that's, you know, we put on the show for you guys. Like, I mean, it's a little extra work for us. And I'm hoping that a lot of you guys at home listening, you know, you're sitting back with a drink and unwinding from the week and listening to us bullshit. And I hope it helps you relax. I hope it makes your life better. That's what we're trying to spread. The people that hate us, they want people to be miserable. But at the end of the day, all we want to do is make people laugh. It's entertainment, it's comedy, and there's always gonna be people that hate that, but they will never stop us from making comedy. That's what we like to do. And I don't know, that's pretty much what I gotta say about it.
Yeah, I gotta pretty much agree with it. That's just the way it is now.
Yeah, I mean, that's it. Yeah.
Back to it, man. Hey, sweet.
Oh, a super chat. Support.
Hey, you don't need to send me money. I dollar, two, 50, 100,000, 20 million. You don't need to send me money, but listen, I appreciate when you guys do. If you want to super chat and send us money, that's great. Because it all goes right back to the show. It all goes right back to you guys. And a lot of people have been doing that lately, sending us fucking money. So, Sweet and Sour Dragon, I appreciate that fucking shit. Thank you very much. If anybody else wants to fucking send us, you know, super chat monies, man, we'll gladly take it off your hands.
Yeah, well, we don't ever want to have a Patreon or any of that bullshit. So if you are insistent on sending us money, super chat is actually the only way that you can send us money.
And we will never ask you for fucking. But that's what you want to do, man. It's going to go right back into the show because I'm trying to buy a new camera this weekend. I want to start dropping fucking more videos, man, and, you know,
God, when you get a new camera, I guess you might as well send me a plane ticket because I need to come just fix your shit.
Ain't nothing wrong with my shit, bitch.
No, there's tons wrong with your shit.
Can we call Scooter back?
No, leave Scooter alone. He's a good Christian man.
Can I call him back as Peter? Just please, just one time.
I mean, go ahead, dude. It's up to you, man.
Type in the chat if you want me to call back. Fucking Scooter.
Poor fucking Scooter. Goddamn Scooter.
Dude. Yeah, they want it, dude.
Of course they do, dude. It's Scooter, dude.
I want to be Peter, though. I want to be like, oh.
All right, be Peter. I don't think it'll last more than, like, 5 seconds, but you give it a shot. All right.
Well, I think it will.
Alright, do it.
Alright. Hang on. Well, I don't know, man. Let me think about it.
That's what I thought. Well, talk about I kinda want to, dude. Well, I mean, it's up to you, but
what if I call as Peter asking for Elton John records?
I mean, you could do that.
Do you know any other gay? Is there any other gay, like,
no,
gay artists?
No, do this one. Do this one, because he'll have this one, and he won't put two and two together. Do Queen.
Oh, okay. All right, yeah. I'll do Elton John, Queen, and
no,
Wham.
No. Just do Queen first. Then you can go from there.
Well, I got to see in the chat. I got to see a bunch of Peter in the chat. I ain't doing it.
Type Peter, Pumpkin Eater.
No, Peter, Cock Eater.
No, Peter, Pumpkin Eater. Dude, we're coming up on October. Let's get some Halloween theme in here a little early. The grocery store.
Let me
do it.
I got to think of a song. Give me a song by, like, Culture Club. Oh, I got one. Give me time to recognize. Wait, how's it? Do you really want to hurt me?
Do you realize as soon as you sing, he's going to hang up. So keep that in mind.
Well, do I get points for keeping him on? I mean, how many points do I get for keeping him on?
If you sing and he stays on.
Please sing. My man Phil Jones wants me to sing. Please sing Heaven is a Place on Earth, Belinda Carlisle.
Oh, baby, do you know what that's worth? Oh,
fuck.
Oh, heaven
and
is
that's a place on earth. Yeah, you
got
it.
I got it. Let me get the number. Dear
God.
All right, here we go. Dude, I hope this guy. I don't want him to call the fucking cops, dude.
Are you blocking your number?
No.
Oh, I did. I blocked my number.
Here we go. Here we go. Oh, how you doing? I was looking for do you have I can't find this record I'm trying to called Wham the Greatest Hits. Oh.
Wham?
Wham.
I don't know. I'd have to go look it up in our system.
Can you look it up? Oh. Can you look it up?
Just go on a second here, sir.
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
I can't believe you made it this far. Congratulations.
Yeah, we got that.
Do you have
Holy
it
shit,
on,
they have Wham Greatest Hits.
Do you have it on, a 45? Because I like 45 inches.
Excuse me?
Do you have it on 45? Oh.
Let's see. Let's see what we got on CD.
Oh, can you put, Oh, can you put one aside for me? I'm going to come get it right now. Ooh.
All right. I can do that for you.
Now, let me ask you a question. I heard a song earlier. I don't know who it is. It goes, can I tell you the lyrics? Because I don't know who it is. sir, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Dun, 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 dun. Blue jean, baby. LA lady. Seems just for the band. Hold the closer, Donnie Dancer. Oh, do you have that? I think it's Elton John. Oh, do you have
John? Sure, yeah, we got a whole bunch of Elton John.
I need the greatest hits because I want the whole.
Yeah, we got plenty of greatest Elton John.
Yeah, but I want the whole package. Oh.
All right, just come on down the store and grab it.
Yeah, put it off to the side. I can't fucking do it. I can't do it, dude. I can't do it. He knew.
That was the sound of a defeated man when you were like, can I tell you the lyrics? And he was like, yeah, whatever. He was like, I guess. Like, he knew what was coming.
I suppose. Can I sing you some lyrics? I suppose. Go ahead. Dude, he knew right away. He's like, hey, can I sing you some lyrics? I suppose. He knew right, dude. You know he's sitting there like, I'm thinking his record store is like the bottom floor of his apartment, and then he lives upstairs. And I think he's just sitting there with no fucking customers, and he gets a call, and he's just all excited.
Well,
like,
I mean, he's got three kids, but he runs a record store that no one buys shit from. It's got to be.
I know he has.
He said he had three kids.
Well, I didn't hear that part.
I was listening. He has three kids.
Well, I'm not calling him back again, dude. I'm gonna leave my man alone.
Yeah, he's defeated, dude. Like next time
we're calling
him. He's gonna go home tonight and have a whiskey and probably listen to the show.
I wanted to call him back and ask him if he had any Tupac, but you pretty much already confirmed that the guy hates rap. What do you
say?
Oh
my god, no, dude, you gotta go back and listen to that because that was one of the best Hank calls ever.
When you asked about R&B, what did he say?
He said like what kind of artists do that, or he didn't understand that it was like black music, because like I'd been asking about rap. He was like, we don't carry much rap, and I was like, that's kind of racist, man. And then he was like, dude, you got to go back and listen to it. That was one of the best Hank calls. And even as he was like, who am I talking to? I'm like, Hank, H-A-N-K. I mean, dude, and I rapped. I rapped that whole riffraff. So, like, I mean, dude, I got 105% on that call, dude. I hit the extra credit and everything.
But he said, and I quote, we have all the Dr. Dre's.
Yeah. And I was like, you got the chronic? And I was like, you're only half racist. I mean, that dude.
I feel bad, dude. I couldn't help but laugh.
Dude,
like,
we gotta.
I suppose he just felt so beat down.
We gotta find more people like Scooter. He was just too good.
Can I sing you some lyrics?
Yeah.
He just felt so beat down. Like, you ain't coming in here and buying shit. He just felt so fucking wrecked. He's like, I suppose.
I actually kind of feel bad now. I kind of want to send him like a gift basket or something. Like,
should I call him back and tell him we were just goofing?
No, I think it's just gonna make it worse.
Well, maybe he has a website. I can send everybody to his website.
No, I don't think you want to send any of our fans to Scooter's website, dude. Yeah, I don't think that's a good idea.
If he does have a website, go and buy like all the records specifically that he talked about.
You should send him a box of records and make sure the Beatles are in there.
I think I'm going to try to fucking call him back off the air and get his PayPal and just give him a couple bucks for playing.
Yeah, I mean, man, dude, he was so funny. Dude,
listen, somebody wants me to call him back as Scooter. I can do that.
What are you doing?
Call him back as Scooter. Hey, this is Scooter, motherfucker.
I don't know, dude. As the producer, I'm saying no. It's too much. It's too much for one night. Just keep that number. We'll call him next week.
Yeah, definitely next week.
We'll call him next week as Scooter. That'll be next week. Come back next week if you want to hear Scooter call Scooter. And you have to be exactly like Scooter.
All right, well, we're on the two-hour mark. I'm getting ready to head out of here. So.
Yeah, I'm kind of hungry and shit. Do we have anything else to talk about?
Well, I want to thank you guys for going along with my ideas and you know, changing everything up, man. It's fucking, it was great that you all, Tyndall, T, Green, I'm glad that you guys wanted to go along with this and do it how I wanted to do it from the get-go. And I needed a change, man. I just can't fucking go anymore associating with absolute nobodies that, whatever. And, you know, maybe we'll do a show tomorrow night if we're all around. Maybe we won't. We'll see what happens. I got to call this guy Monday morning, and maybe we'll do a show Wednesday or Tuesday or Thursday. Who knows what the fuck, but I will keep you all updated with this whole situation because I'm tired of it. I want to be away from it. I want to be just gone with it. I don't want any part of it anymore.
Yeah, we got so many other things to talk about.
So, with that being said, and without any further ado, once again, man, I appreciate everything, and I thank you guys for everything you guys done, and check out vapebright.org and the Billy Goat Chip Company, and, you know, buy their products. Go over there, do some shopping, and other than that, man, Tyndall, close out the show, and we'll see you guys when we see you, man. I'm out. Peace.
Peace. T, what you got?
Not much. To see you guys either next week or tomorrow, whichever we do. But I'll see you guys there.
Stay tuned to Twitter, and we'll let you guys know. Peace, guys. All right, guys. I don't even know if I really feel like playing a song. So.